After the breaking of the bread and the taking of the cup, Jesus came out and went, as was his custom, to the Mount of Olives, and his disciples followed him. And when he came to the place, he said unto them,
Pray that you may not enter into temptation.
And he withdrew from them about a stone's throw, and knelt down and prayed, saying,
Father, if thou art willing, remove this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done.
And there appeared to him an angel from heaven, strengthening him.
And being in agony, he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat became like great drops of blood falling down upon the ground. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no man than this, that he lay down his life for his friends.
Then Pilate took Jesus and scourged him, and the soldiers plaited a crown of thorns and put it on his head. And they put on him a purple robe and said, "Hail, King of the Jews!"
Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and he who loves is born of God and knows God.
They took Jesus, and he went out, bearing his own cross, to the place which is called Golgotha. And there they crucified him with two others, one on either side, and Jesus between them.
There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear. We love because he first loved us.
After this, Jesus, knowing that all things were now accomplished, said, "I thirst." And they put a sponge full of vinegar on hyssop and held it to his mouth. When Jesus had received the vinegar, he said, "It is finished," and bowed his head and gave up his spirit.